Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan had appointed his third son, Prince Shah Shuja, as the Subedar of Bengal, Bihar and Orissa. Though Prince Shuja would hold his court at Rajmahal in Bihar, he would occasionally visit Bengal. During his visits, Prince Shuja used to stay at this Tahkhana complex. Tahkhana literally means a room built below ground level for the purpose of private retreat. The Tahkhana complex is situated less than half a mile west from Chota Shona Mosque and 2 miles south from the Kotwali Darwaza in Chapai Nawabganj district. The complex comprises of three structures: the Tahkhana itself, a mosque, and the Mazar complex of Shah Niamatullah, who was known to be a murshid of Prince Shah Shuja. The mosque, locally known as Shah Niamatullah Mosque, has typical Mughal architecture. The mosque has three domes, with the central dome a little larger than the flanking ones. All the domes are topped by decorative concrete finials. There are slender columns at the corners of the mosque. The columns are also topped by concrete finials. The eastern wall of the mosque has three entrances, all of equal sizes. There are merlon decorations on the edges of the roof. The western wall is embellished with sunken panels. Inside the mosque, the western wall has just one arched mihrab. The mihrab is flanked by two arched sunken frames. All the domes of the mosque are vaulted from inside. The domes are supported on walls using two arches. There are merlon decorations on the inside of the central dome also. The walls are embedded with niches, those used to hold lamps. The tomb complex of Shah Niamatullah is a square with one dome in the center. Each side of the building has three doors. The four corners have four columns. The compound of the tomb complex has a large number of graves, possibly of murids of Shah Niamatullah. Some of these graves have a stone sarcophagus, while others have Turkish-style headstone. The Tahkhana itself is a two-storied structure with one story below ground level. From the west, the building gives an appearance of a single-storied structure with three arched entrances. The entrance leads to a Betakhana, a place for the prince to meet his visitors. The meeting room has a domical roof with traditional Mughal design on the inside. Besides the meeting room, there are several rooms in one line in the north-south direction. All the rooms are similarly constructed with niches embedded in the walls. The south side of the building has a hammam with arrangements for heating water. Water is supplied to the hammam from an octagonal house at one side of the building. One of the doorways near the hammam has the only existing carved sandstone features of the building. There is a small mosque at the north end of the building. The mosque has three mihrabs on the western wall. A narrow staircase leads to the Tahkhana below the ground level. The Tahkhana faces a large body of water on the east, thus making this more like a Hawakhana. There are large arched openings towards the water. This was the place for private retreat. The Tahkhana complex as a whole is important not only from the point of view of its being Mughal in a sultanate city, but the component buildings by themselves have much significance because of their architectural nature being first introduced in Bengal. Once they were introduced, they became the prototype for subsequent erections, be that a palace, a mosque, or a tomb in the subsequent Mughal capitals in Dhaka or Murshidabad. Thank you.